Well, howdy YouTube family, it's Bolt CRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. Today we're going to be talking about a topic everyone wants to talk about when they talk to me about CRNA stuff. It's money. Everyone wants to know about the income and the salaries and the money. So today we're going to get into it. We're going to get into the top 10 best paying states for CRNAs, what you actually get paid there, and what states those are. So you know you can hitch a ride on over to that state and get a job. And I'm also going to touch on three of the states that are the worst paying states that actually are well below market value and I would steer clear of. Let's get into it. So we're gonna go backwards from the 10th to the number one at the end here. So let's start with the 10th best paying state, which is Virginia. Virginia is one of the original 13th colonies. It's a very old state. It's on the East Coast, of course, for those of you who don't know. It's got a lot of history, Revolutionary War stuff. It's a very pretty state. The unemployment rate is only 6.3%, and the property taxes are only 0.8%, which is actually below average for the nation. Its state capital is Richmond, Virginia, and the largest city that's actually in Virginia is Virginia Beach. Now, remember, Washington, D.C. is right on the corner of Virginia, so some people kind of add that in with Virginia because it's so connected there. But that's not part of Virginia, technically. The total population is around 8.5 million people. And the weather is pretty variable. In the winters, it gets pretty cold, like 25 degrees or so. And then it says, in the Wikipedia page, says that up in the summers, it gets up into like the 80s and 90s. So pretty typical for that area. You've got the water on one side, you've got mountains on another side. Overall, pretty state. And when you look up things to do there, you've got stuff like Colonial Williamsburg, there's some ranches. It's a lot of outdoorsy stuff there. On to number 9, Washington State. Now, Washington has actually got a population of 7.6 million people. It's, of course, up in the upper left side of the U.S., which is bordered by the Pacific Ocean and has lots of mountains. It's got Seattle up there, although the state capital is actually Olympia. Washington's an interesting state because most of the people live on the western side bordering the water, and then there's a huge stretch of mountainside there. And then once you go past that mountainside, it's kind of very sparse population. There's not many cities or people out that way. Because there's such big elevation changes in this state, the average temperature is all over the place. It says here on Wikipedia 51 degrees Fahrenheit, but at some of the peaks it says there's like negative 48 Fahrenheit is at times recorded, and then other times temperatures can be 118. I would say average, my brother lives in this state right now, I would say it's pretty temperate climate there. It definitely gets colder in the winter. It can get fairly warm in the summers, but not like sweltering heat. Seattle area is always misty and kind of rainy over there if you like that kind of weather. On to number 8. I almost said 8, but I guess I could hold it up. 8, North Dakota. This state is got a pretty similar salary to Washington. It's just barely more than Washington. North Dakota's is $194,570 as an annual salary for a CRNA. North Dakota borders Canada up there. It's a very cold state. It's known for cold weather. Its capital is Bismarck. As far as fun facts for North Dakota, it says it leads the nation in production of spring wheat, durum wheat, dry edible peas, dry edible beans, honey, flaxseed, and canola. And it's number one producer for honey in the nation. But I would say outside of those facts, there's not too much else to know about North Dakota. If you want to live out there, you know, you could make pretty good money, and it looks like it would not be expensive to live there, so that your money may take you pretty far. On to number 7, Hawaii. Now, Hawaii, beautiful state. I love Hawaii. A lot of people, anyone who goes there pretty much loves it. But the thing is, Hawaii is not even connected to the rest of the continental US. It's out in the ocean, and it's a series of islands. Its capital is Honolulu, has a population of 1.4 million. Now, the caveat to this is Hawaii is also very expensive. It may be one of the only states we've mentioned so far. It is. It's the only state we've mentioned so far that's like significantly more expensive than national average. Your money while it sounds like you're getting really paid well, it's not going to take you very far in Hawaii. But again, this is like a paradise vacation place of things to do there. There's volcanoes, national parks, the ocean everywhere. These are places that people travel from all over the world just to visit. So you kind of pay the premium for living there. The homes are very expensive. Land is very expensive. Number six, Nevada. Nevada is a pretty big size state, but there's not as much population there for the size. 3.08 million. It borders California and Arizona and Utah. What I know about Nevada is typically, you know, of course, Vegas. Everyone knows Las Vegas is in Nevada. Outside of that, and maybe I think Reno, there is not that much going on in that state. It's kind of a sparsely populated area. The taxes are supposed to be pretty good there. I know a lot of people like to go out there to buy real estate and do investments and stuff out there because you can get a lot more for your money. So your money there, if you're making $196,000 in Nevada, that's actually going to take you pretty far. So that's not a bad deal, but you would have to be okay living in Nevada. Like I mentioned, there's not much to do outside of Vegas, and not a lot of people want to live somewhere like Vegas. I've heard a lot of problems about drugs and issues like that, bad school systems and stuff in Vegas. So yeah, maybe you wouldn't want to live there and raise your kids there. But as far as climates and stuff, it's desert. You know, it's desert climate. So it's very warm or very hot during the day, and it might be very cold in the evenings. Number five, Iowa. Now, this is one of our Midwestern states. I don't think we've mentioned any of these like classic kind of what people consider flyover states yet, but Iowa would be one of those, and you can make $198,000 there as a CRNA on average. So Iowa's right between the Mississippi River and Missouri, mostly known for rolling plains and cornfields. Population of 3.1 million. Capital is Des Moines, which is a fairly decent sized city. When I Google what's Iowa famous for, it says it's known as the Hawkeye State. Also says it has the most pigs of any state and is the nation's top pork producer. You know, Iowa is a good old farming community. You know, this big state full of farming and rolling hills and, you know, cold winters. So if you want to live in that and that's your vibe, then your money could take you a far way there. So that's good. On to number four, Oregon. Oregon is actually right above the state that I live. I live in California, and so Oregon is right above us. It is a pretty state. You've got the coast right there. It's, you know, Pacific coastline. It's not too cold in the winter. It does get kind of colder than what I prefer, but definitely not like some of the other states. Pretty mild summers. Its population is 4.2 million, which I'm actually surprised by because Oregon is a fairly rural state besides Portland. That majority of those people must live in Portland because Portland is really their big city. Their capital is Salem. The median home cost is $344,000 there, whereas the average in the United States is $231,000. So as you can see there, Oregon is more expensive than the typical U.S. state for housing and many other things too. Fun fact is, Portland is home to the only leprechaun colony west of Ireland. Hey, and it's also one of the few states without a sales tax. Portland is ranked among top destination cities for relocation in several surveys, this says. Oregon also has more ghost towns than any other state, apparently. So overall, not bad. Oregon sounds like a pretty good mix of good pay of $207,000, and the cost of living is pretty low. Now we're entering into the top three states, the best paying states for CRNA. So let's see how these go. Number three, California. Who saw that coming? California offers $217,000 of annual salary for a typical CRNA. And I would say that's actually seems a little low, but maybe there are lower places paying in this state somewhere. Let's see a little bit about California. So of course it's bordered on for 900 miles by the Pacific Ocean, lots and lots of beaches. It's famous for LA and it's San Diego and it's SoCal kind of beaches. And then NorCal has totally different types of beaches, rocky, and where I live in the Bay Area near San Francisco. You know, you have Hollywood and the movie industry and all that kind of stuff. A lot of movie stars live in this state. There's 39.5 million people who live in California. And that is a huge population. Obviously, you see from the other states we mentioned, that is many, many, many times more than the population. Unemployment rate is 11.6%, and there is a huge homeless population here. I will say, out of any place I've lived, I've never this many homeless people that I've noticed here. I'll also say taxes here, probably the worst in the United States as far as fees and taxes. Your taxes, I mean, it's outrageous how much you get taxed. You get taxed for breathing, for standing, for seeing, anything that you can do here, you get a tax on. But you also have access to Disneyland, Golden Gate Bridge, Yosemite National Park, you know, Joshua Tree. There's just so many things here in this state that is just, whether it be actual environmental marvels like Yosemite National Park, which almost feels like you're in a different planet. How pretty and massive the waterfalls are and these giant rock formations and stuff. Different types of ocean and beaches and stuff everywhere here. You've got the Pacific Coast Highway. You've got everything that, you know, you can think of to do in LA. Year-round good weather. It's mostly summer here all year round. You can be outdoors hiking and jogging and having fun outdoors, enjoying the vitamin D and the sunshine pretty much 365 days a year. It's not much rain. The downside is the lack of rain causes fires to happen. Usually once a year you have fire season, which can be a terrible time for some, depending on what part of the state you live in. And here lately it's been getting worse. Overall, people love California. Your money's not gonna take you very far here because homes are like $1 million in most places here. But it is a very pretty state to live in, and I enjoy it. Our number two state is Wyoming. Now, Wyoming is surrounded by Idaho, Montana, Nebraska, South Dakota, Colorado. It's right there smack dab in the middle, landlocked. It's a very square state. The total population for the whole state is 578,000 people. When you type in things to do, it's pretty much all outdoors things. Grand Teton National Park, which actually looks pretty. Old Faithful, which is an old geyser, and a Grand Prismatic Spring, which looks pretty interesting. Devil's Tower National Monument. So essentially these are all like pretty outdoor adventure things you can do. It's famous for Yellowstone and actually has 7 national parks. So there's lots of tourists that come to Wyoming to visit its national parks every year. So it says that Wyoming's a kind of, it describes it as a rugged American wilderness and free range living. So I think that'd be pretty accurate. A lot of open spaces, lots of outdoor stuff. The taxes are fairly low there. There's not many people there. And if you don't like a lot of outdoorsy activities, maybe you wouldn't like it very much. But your money would take you pretty far there. I mean, $250,000 in a place that's low cost of living like that, you could afford a lot of things. And the number one, drum roll please, top paying state in the United States for CRNAs is Montana. Montana comes in at $252,000 a year for average CRNA salary. That is our top as of the last year's recordings. Let's talk a little bit about Montana. Do you want to live in Montana? Montana's capital is Helena. Its population is 1.069 million people, a little bit more than Wyoming. It's bordered by Canada on the top end there. It gets very cold in the winter, obviously. It's lots of hiking, outdoor stuff. There's the Glacier National Park is there. So essentially both our top two picks here are gonna be pretty wide open spaces. If you're liking outdoors activity, not much people, not really any big cities, but good pay and fairly cheap cost of living. So maybe that would be your best bet. Maybe especially after graduating school and wanting to pay off student loans, that could be an option for you. All right, so that was the top 10 best paying states, but let's do a brief talk about the 3 worst paying states. So the 3rd worst paying state is Georgia, and it's coming in at $145,210 a year for a CRNA. That's a terribly low salary. I lived in Georgia as a kid growing up for some years, and it's not a very expensive state. I would say that outside of Atlanta, which can be fairly expensive, most places in Georgia are pretty reasonable. You can get a good amount for your money, but I would say $145,000 is ridiculously low. And the only reason I would say that the pay is that low in that state is because Atlanta has quite a bit of anesthesia assistance there. And any city where you're gonna have, or state that has a lot of anesthesia assistance where they're allowed to practice, it's gonna bring the salary for CRNAs down. That's probably the problem that has happened in Georgia, and mostly Atlanta specifically. So I would hope to see that come up in the future because my family's from, you know, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee, and, you know, maybe one day I would live there again, but not with salaries like that. The second worst paying state is Arizona. Now, Arizona is coming in at $139,000 a year. That is terribly low. Arizona is not a terribly expensive place to live. And I actually have some friends that live in Arizona, and I would consider living in Arizona one day. I would not work for that salary though. And I will say that my friends who live there, they don't work for that salary. So I don't know if these are old numbers or these are just skewed some. I do know the salaries are a little bit less there. But of course, Arizona is kind of like desert environment outside of Phoenix. There's not much city or much happening there, not much population. I know some CRNAs that own practices in Arizona. They do much, much better than that. So I assume that has to go along with because they own their own practice. 139, no bueno. Arizona, you got to get that up. In the number one worst paying state on this list is Rhode Island at $133,000 a year. Now, I have to imagine that Rhode Island just does not have many anesthesia practices. Maybe they don't have many CRNAs, so the numbers are just skewed here. They weren't able to get a good sample size. I can't imagine that that is legitimately a normal salary. I've never heard of anyone paying that low in this day and age. Maybe like 25 years ago, that was someone making that kind of salary, but nothing anytime recent. I think we should look more into that with Rhode Island and see what the details are. If you're from Rhode Island or you know people from Rhode Island, you know, hit me up down below. I can't say I don't know anyone from Rhode Island. Hit me up down below in the comments and let me know, is this a normal salary for there? I can't imagine that Rhode Island is extremely wildly cheaper than everywhere else to live. This doesn't make sense to me. I would definitely not live there for that price for certain. So that should be get remedied if it's true. But I want to hear from you guys. What state do you want to live in? California, obviously, it's where I live. It's on the top end of the list, and it actually has cities and things to do there. But again, the caveat to that is there's extreme taxes here. Your money doesn't take you very far, pretty much paying to live here. So yeah, which of these states would you say would be your top pick? And if none of these are it and you want to do a whole different state, let me know why. I want to hear down below. I'm interested. Maybe I'll move there myself. Who knows? All right, guys, that was my list of all the top states. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. Join the subscription and do the mentorship plan over there if you're interested in becoming a CRNA or getting into CRNA school. I have study guides over there. I have behind the scenes videos. I do mock interviews with you guys if you're on the Ketamine Kings membership level, and that's bolt out.